Welcome to my photography class. In this lesson, you will learn what ISO is and how it affects exposure. ISO is the level of sensitivity of your camera sensor to the light that hits the sensor. In basic terms, ISO is simply a camera setting that digitally makes your image brighter or darker. Increasing the ISO makes it brighter, while decreasing makes it darker. ISO options changing depending on your camera, but usually start at 100 and go up by the power of 2, like 100, 200, 400, 800, 1600 and so on. Even some cameras have them in between. Some newer cameras can go all the way up into the millions. However, raising your ISO has consequences. Because you are digitally enhancing your image, a photo taken at high ISO will show a lot of grains or digital noise and might not be usable. So brightening a photo via ISO is always a trade-off. You should only raise your ISO when you are unable to expose the photo via shutter speed or aperture. Here are two images with the same camera at different ISO settings. If we zoom in, we can see the difference. The image shot at higher ISO has much digital noise or grain as compared to image shot at ISO 100. Now one other thing that I want to discuss is what is native and base ISO. We will cover in depth about this in another video. Very briefly, the lowest native ISO is the lowest ISO number of your camera. Most modern cameras have the lowest ISO of 100. So ideally, you would be shooting at ISO 100 to get the highest quality image. This lowest native ISO is also the base ISO of your camera. Now, if your base ISO is 100, then the upper native ISO settings go up by the power of 2, like 200, 400, 800 and so on. While it steps in between, like 125, 160, 250, 320, are called non-native. Now it's your turn. Take some pictures from your camera and see what ISO is good and which ones have a lot of noise and grains, by which you can get a clear idea of the highest ISO level of your camera for good pictures. Thank you for watching it. Good day.